Thank you for following us so much. And today we are on our day six of our positive thinking workout. It's not just about sitting down in the house to think. That's not what positive thinking is all about. It's all about doing things that are actively, you know, engaging your mind, your soul, and your body, instead of engaging yourself in things that breed fear and pain and discouragement. So this week we've been looking at, from day one we talked about distracting yourself, self-distraction, which helps you to think about something different, thinking, meditation, and prayers as a Christian. And also we also talked about, in day three, we talk about focusing on small things like you know, like a family, like food, like nutrition, like the children, and even around your house. So we also talked about on day four, we talked about reframing the situation, looking at some positive things that you can glean from the pains or the difficulty that's going on around the world today. Also talk about cleaning up the house on the five. We clean up the house, and then that was the last yesterday. We talked about cleaning the house and the five. And so you can clean your house, repaint the house, put new wallpapers, and rearrange the furniture on the wall, and see how better that your house can look, especially for the COVID-19 era. We're in the COVID-19 era anyways. So in this period of time that we are, we have to think of something we can do to keep our minds and souls busy, instead of focusing on the problem. Let's focus on something else, the reverse side, because in every good there is evil, in every evil there is good. So let's look at something positive in this evil that we are going through. So today we talk about management of social media consumption. So manage your social media consumption. A lot of people are posting all sort of lies and ignorant messages, sharing things that breed fear. What do you do? If you stay too long on social media, you lose your peace. So maybe you can manage your social media consumption and use more time for your family, more time for sleep that you have missed for so long. Use more time for the people around you. Maybe phone family members that you haven't had time to talk to in years. Maybe take up time. If you have unlimited call minutes, you call all your friends, like 1,000 friends you have in your call book that you think you can talk to. Spend time with them over the phone and just enjoy the moment. Trust me, you may never have a time like this. Babe, I've not heard anyone tell me there was a lockdown in history, except the one I read in the Bible in the day when the Samaria was locked down by the Syrians. But in the present generation, I've not heard of any time that the country was locked down. And not just one country, the whole world is locked down and businesses stopped. So I want to encourage you to use this time profitably and manage your social media consumption, instead of you peddling with news. Don't share those things. Don't share all this information. They say, oh, read this and share it to other people. Don't share them, because when you share them, you put another person in that tension, that fear that you have. You, instead of transferring that fear, transfer messages like this, positive messages like this to them, and then help other people to stay positive instead of helping them to live in fear. There could be news you transfer to someone and the person reads it and falls down and dies. You kill the person. So we should stop. Stop it, please. Stop sharing bad news. Stop sharing news that breed fear. At this time, make sure you share only things that encourage people to stay positive and to stay healthy at this time. I want you to use today as a day, your workout today is to delete all the negative messages that you have received. And then make up your mind that from today, you're not going to share them. And only share what is positive, what can encourage other people, what can help other people to stay healthy and positive at this time. I'll see you tomorrow. I do hope that you stay healthy and stop sharing fake news about COVID-19. Thank you very much.